guys, welcome. This is Unfinished. My name is SK Gitonga. Thank you for joining. Today, we're talking about corruption. Corruption entails a few activities like fraud and embezzlement of funds, which takes us to our first question. According to you, what is corruption? Let me know in the comment section.
Corruption is a form of dishonesty. You want to get a certain service, but for you to get that service, you have to, ni kama lazima ukanje mtu kitu, ndio upate your service. Like, I want to go to a certain office to get a certain service. Let's say I am applying for a passport. For me to get that passport, I have to, lazima nikanje mseye fulani hapo, ndio nipate your passport within a certain period of time. So, corruption ni yo process yenye iko na yo dishonesty. For me to get a certain service, lazima nitoe a certain amount of money. Yeah.
According to me, corruption ni anything unafanya enye unapita mapanya route kando kando nini nini, anything that is not the correct process, ndio corruption.
According to me, corruption is basically cutting corners using the resources you have. Mostly in Kenya, what we have is using money to get what you want. That is, if you want a job, if you want, you know, a favor, or you want a contract. Most people tend to use money. Can also, for women, you use sexual favors to get a job, or, you know, just something. And yeah, like I said before, it's basically cutting corners to get something you essentially don't deserve because you didn't go through the right process.
Ni kitu yenye lazima ili upate kitu, lazima utoe kitu. Adi hii huwa inaanza tukiwa wadogo, wazazi wanakuambia fanya hii alafu nitakupea sweetie. I think hiyo ni corruption. Una grow up for example, kama unataka kujoin shule huko, maybe uko placed, then unakuja kwa shule unajaribu kwamba nafasi na wanakunyima. So now the best way ni kuwa bribe. I think pia bribery ni corruption. Ni vizuri sote tuko honest. Kama uko qualify kwenda kwa hii university, ukienda kwa ingine unaweza kubaliwa. Maybe hii iko level yake iko juu kidogo, but ukienda kwa ingine unaweza pewa nafasi. So corruption, yeah, I think you inamaanisha corruption.
Mostly embezzlement of funds and hiding of wrongdoings. Like you sweep under the rug things like murder, rape, all that.
Yep. Corruption ni ufisadi.
Explain.
Corruption unapata, unatumia njia yenye si ya haki kupata kitu. Kama unapata, maybe kuna services inapeanwa, wewe unatoa, unapata unatoa something else. Unapata unakuwa considered kuliko mtu mwenye the other person. Unapata kama maybe kwa services unaweza pata watu walikuwa wamepanga lie, but wewe maybe umetoa hongo, unaona, unapeana hiyo hongo na mwingine maybe ana hiyo hongo. Sasa unapata unakuwa considered kuliko hiyo mtu mwingine. So unapata that kind of corruption. Pia ama pia kwa kazi unapata unatoa pesa ndio ajiria, na hiyo ni kitu inakuaga tu often kila mahali. Kwa kila siku hizi ni kama iko kila mahali, juu lazima utumie pesa ndio upate sijui pesa, wanasema hivyo.
Corruption iko kila mahali Kenya. Hata huku kwa barabara kumejaa hizo. Unaona tu kama polisi wanasimamisha gari instead ya kuangalia kama everything, kama gari insurance iko updated nini, wanachukua kitu kidogo, wanaacha hizo magari zinaenda, lakini hakuna yenye si hiyo. Hiyo ndio sasa nasema ndio corruption.
Ni kupagua watu according vile unapagua mtu, vile unamwangalia tu, unaona huyu according to classes, unaona huyu mtu si wa class yako. So ikifika hata time ya kuandika kazi, kama mtu ni maskini, you prefer mtu mwenye ako na pesa kuliko huyo mwenye ni maskini.
Corruption is actually a killer, a dead killer aspect in society. Why should I call it a dead killer in society? Because when you enter into corruption, you are making that society to drain off, not to have services, not to have what it entails as a community. So corruption kills. And corruption kills in the long run. not in the short run. Take up example. I was giving an example. Like a person who has been involved in corruption, when he retires, he doesn't have that quick money. Now he doesn't become a value to himself while he was working. So corruption, that's just an example. Corruption is not good. And also, look at corruption. Those people are stole from the county governments. Those people have stole from where? They have made those government, county government insolvent. No project going on, no development going on. But another aspect is, when these people are set free, it is the mwananchi who is it, they should sell the proceeds, go back to the county government, to the way it is, so that development can be done. Yeah. Look at the millions which were lost in Kiambu. People are just there. The cases are in court. How long will the cases be in court? And the people of Kiambu, for example, they don't have the services. Yeah.
For me, corruption, I think it's about money. So, like, you can apply a job genuinely with your skills, but you can't get with, in some areas, you can't get the job without paying a bribe. So for me, I think corruption is when you're using money to get what you can just get for free, or use when you like to say ukiona skills zako, but you still need to have the money to get that job. Na bado kuna hizo skills.
Corruption, I think, is using public resources for your personal wants, or for your personal needs. Like, you're using something that was supposed to be used by someone else. Yeah, I think that is corruption.
So according to me, corruption is basically when you give something to get things flow in your favor. It doesn't have to be money. It could be some sort of service. I mean, we have seen this. We have examples of it, like, on our roads every day. Sometimes when someone's looking for a job, and they are well qualified, but there's like a large number of people trying to get the same job. So at the end of the day, you find out that you have to give up money to get what you want. Which takes us to our next question. What do you think are the side effects of corruption? Let me know what you think in the comments section. It's right to fight for and finished.
Major corruption, okay, it's becoming interesting, but corruption is a cancer. When I get like, in answer and dog, in a spread, paka, akuna kitu in a function. So I would say, yeah, that's the effect. It basically, it's corruption stops things from working. Although people use corruption because they think that's what makes things work.
According to me, side effects for corruption is, one, you make other people miss out on a chance they really deserve because you think you're better than them, and you think because you have certain kind of things, certain kind of resources, you feel above them even though you don't have the training. So you make that person, you know, miss out on an opportunity that will really help them and help the society around them. And also another thing is it leaves a lot of people jobless, you know, because if somebody was not really qualified in doing something, and let's say he's having a letter like 10k cash saying, oh, I can do this job. Of course, the person employing will be like, this is 10k, I can put it in my pocket and I can put him in the job. So the person who is actually deserving it will end up jobless because this person with 10k, I'm a schooler because he has the money or she has the money.
Corruption, most of the time, it is bring about tribalism. Do, for example, in the working sector, but in most, especially in private institutions, hospitals, unapata ukienda kwa hospital unapata ni kabila fulani tu ndo the majority. As much as we have these other tribes, kuna tu the majority. Obviously, this employer alikuwa anatafuta watu wa tribe yake. Sasa una corruption imekujia hapo, juu yeye ukikuja kutafuta kazi kwake, ana like akiangalia kwa documents anaona huyu si wa kabila yetu, so huyu atawapea the wa mwisho, acha nichukue wa kwetu, and then hao watakuwa the last option.
Effects of corruption, maybe kuna unemployment kwa inchi, unapata watu watakuwa employed juu unapata someone else mwenye maybe ulikuwa na skills mingi kumliko, unapata yeye amekuwa ameajiriwa na wewe umeachwa kando, unaona? Kwa hivyo ni kumashamba unapata watu less wanakuwa wanakuwa employed, unaona? Unapata maybe kama ratio inafaa ikuwe 1:5, unapata wana employ 1:3, unaona? Yale watu wawili extra unapata wameko kwa mfuko, unaona? Bado unapata bado kuna ile bado level umaskini, unapata yezi rudi chini, unaona? Itazidi tu kupanda, unapata maskini anazidi kuwa maskini, tajira kitajirika, unaona? So unapata watu wengi, unapata inchi, unapata Wakenya wanazidi kuwa kuishi kwa maskini, shida zinakuwa mingi, ekonomi inakuwa ngumu juu hakuna sasa kazi. Watu pesa ya kazi wenye watu walikuwa ajiriwe kazi kwa vijana, watu wamekuliwa pesa, wameko kwa mfuko.
Mambo ya crime itaendelea, criminal. Ebuni, kama sasa hizo vile nimeeleza, kama hiyo mambo ya mapolisi kwa barabara, hata maybe wana vitu mbaya zinapita zikiwa kwa gari, juu hao hata washughuliki nini, hawataki kujua ni nini iko kwa hizo magari ama nini. Maybe vitu illegal zinapita huko ndani. Sasa unapata kama madawa za kulevya ni mingi, vijana wanatumia tu madawa za kulevya mingi, mnashindwa wazazi wanashindwa kwenye hizo mavitu zinatokanga, kumbe zinapitanga tu huku kwa barabara kama kawaida tu, lakini hakuna mtu ana mind, hata polisi hawa mind. Burake tu ya kipata pesa, yes, hiyo ingine shida yenu. Sasa
sometimes inaleta fight, sasa kama tuseme tulipali simu, kama umeandika wakisiu kaja wajaruo, sia wajaruo watafight, mbona wao wajaandikwa, nyinyi mmeandikwa? It means fight among some people. Eh, na inaweza leta hatred, watu wana hate each other, wanasema sasa kama sisi si wa maana, hawa ni wa maana.
Scarce opportunities. Sema, like, unapata watu wengi wako hawana job because of corruption. You get someone mwenye ameenda shure, akona certificate zaka, amepita vizuri, akona skills, but he can't get the job kama hana hizo pesa. You see, sema, for instance, kuna umaskini. Na mtu ameamua, amejitolea tu, amesoma, kuna grade four, akona skills, but sasa hana hiyo nini pesa ya kublaibu na pati yo pesa, nini yo kazi. So it comes as a challenge yapo.
It puts a lot of strain in the working class. Na pia it causes a lot of lack of trust among the people. Kasa vile tuko tunaargue kati ya Uhuru, vile Uhuru alikuwa, vile watu walikuwa naona do ikienda, but our gene end up, so it let a lot of distrust na a lot of tribalism and all that. Yeah.
The effects of corruption is undevelopment. That is one. The effects of corruption is also senseless or undeveloped, or let me call it a community, because corruption affects the community or the population. You don't look like if there is government, because you are just there, people are eating the money, you have no roads. So once we come to infrastructure in a system and the infrastructure is not working, it means corruption has taken place. Because if we don't have corruption, we shall have infrastructure in all now the devolved governments. We shall have infrastructure. The living standards from each and every household will be uplifted. So that affects the community. That's the effects of corruption.
Number one, the major side effect of corruption is unemployment. Because I know most people, when you talk about corruption, they think it's the hongo that the traffic police take at roads. That's the first thing that you think about corruption. But number one thing that corruption brings is unemployment. Because you give a bribe to someone so that you may be employed, and yet you're not qualified. Yet there's someone who has the certificate, he has all the requirements, but because he or she doesn't have the bribe, then he doesn't get the opportunity to work because you've bribed someone so that you may be employed somewhere. So number one thing that is one of the side effects is corruption is unemployment. Yeah. So that is number one. Number two, there is economic growth. Like when you employ people who are not qualified, they are degrading our economy. Like they don't have the capability to work, and they don't have the skills. So you find that when people go to maybe hospitals and they find doctors who are not qualified, then the quality of services that they provide itakuwa a bit low. So I think those are the major effects of corruption.
There is inequality kwa sababu kuna mse atapata hiyo pesa na kuna mwingine hataweza kupata hiyo pesa. So by the end of the day, mwenye amepata hiyo pesa atapata hiyo service na mwenye haku manage kupata hiyo dough ni kumaanisha hatapata hiyo nini service nye alikuwa anataka. Yeah. So kutakuwa na hiyo inequality and because as a country hatuwezi toshana kipesa. Kuna mwenye atapata a certain, kama ni umeitishwa 70,000, kuna mwenye atapata hiyo siku, kuna mwingine atateka a month diyo aipate. Yeah.
Personally, I think some of the side effects of corruption are, first of all, stagnation of the country. Let's say people went to school, they studied, but then they have the necessary requirements to get a job, but they do not get that job because they do not have enough money, or rather someone else offered more than they actually did. That means the people that end up being employed are people who are inexperienced, they don't have creativity in that certain sector, and there's no new innovation coming in. Secondly, we could have loss of lives. This is far-fetched, but think about it. Someone corrupted their way to get school papers, corrupted their ways to get the job. You become a doctor, you're likely to do something that you're not supposed to do, and that might actually cause a life. Let's take a short break. We'll be back with two more questions.